today we're taking a look at a character of fairly monumental importance, Sabo. As a young boy, Sabo made up the final part of the triangle of Luffy's childhood friends. Together with Ace, the three of them made a promise to each other to become great pirates one day. However, unlike Luffy and Ace, Sabo was actually born into nobility on the island of Goa. At the age of 10, Sabo came to the realization that he was nothing more than a mechanism for his parents to gain more wealth. They showed no care whatsoever for Sabo, and only aspired for him to marry a royal princess in order to keep their family name intact. As a result, Sabo fled to the Grey Terminal, which was a massive junkyard where people lived in poverty and squalor outside of the noble city. He would go on to meet both Ace and Luffy and become brothers with them through the ritual sharing of sake cups. Unfortunately, his lineage would come back to haunt him as Sabo's father, with the help of the Blue Gem Pirates, would force him to return to the world of nobility by threatening to kill Ace and Luffy. However, after discovering a plot to burn down the Grey Terminal, Sabo ran away once more in order to attempt to save the people living there. While none of the nobles cared for what Sabo said, he would run into a very fortunate figure by the name of Monkey D. Dragon. Sabo informed Dragon of what the world nobles had planned on doing, and Dragon was able to use his powers to save most of the inhabitants, offering them a chance to join the revolutionary army. In what was now becoming a pattern, Sabo was then caught again by his parents, and yes, you guessed it, he managed to escape his parents for a third time. As the oldest amongst his friendship trio, Sabo decided it was time to set out on his journey, much the same way Luffy and Ace would eventually come to do so. However, upon departure, his vessel was shot down by the ship of a world noble, offended at the very idea that a commoner would dare cross their path. This would lead both Ace and Luffy to believe that Sabo was dead for much of their lives. However, the truth is that Sabo was rescued by Dragon and raised to eventually become the chief of staff of the entire revolutionary army. He grew into a fairly carefree individual, much like Luffy and Ace, and despite being raised by a noble family, he is very down to earth. He possesses a fair few of Luffy's mannerisms, most notably the tendency to mispronounce people's names. Sabo is also fiercely loyal to those he cares for, and despite being second in command of the revolutionary army, he will forego the army's objective in favor of helping or protecting his comrades. Why didn't Luffy or Ace hear from him in all this time? Especially since they both became quite infamous in their own way. Well, it's because alongside Sabo's physical injuries, he also suffered amnesia. His memories would only tragically return after learning of Ace's death at the Battle of Marineford. He would become incapacitated by grief for 3 days. However, he would eventually learn that Luffy survived the battle, and Sabo vowed to protect him, never wishing to feel the pain of losing a brother again. And 2 years later, the two would finally meet again. Sabo, alongside with Koala and Hack, were assigned to Dressrosa to investigate the underground weapons operation managed by Don Quixote Doflamingo. Luffy also happened to be there on the island at the time, with Trafalgar Law conducting their own, much less subtle operation. However, Luffy got caught up in a gladiatorial tournament, the winner of which would be given Ace's old devil fruit, the Mera Mera no Mi. Sabo made his presence known to Luffy, and upon their reunion, Luffy withdrew himself from the tournament and allowed Sabo to compete in his place. In disguise, of course. The tournament had no official ending, as Sabo kind of just destroyed the arena and stole the Mera Mera no Mi, but as a result he now has the ability to conjure, manipulate, and become fire in the same way that Ace did. Sabo would go on to play quite an important role for the remainder of the Dressrosa arc. He occupied Admiral Fujitora and fought him to a stalemate, before Fujitora finally decided to bet on Luffy beating Doflamingo. Sabo also saved Luffy's life at the climax of the arc by fighting and defeating Jesus Burgess of the Blackbeard Pirates, who was going to kill Luffy and acquire his devil fruit. After Doflamingo's defeat, Sabo left Dressrosa with his fellow revolutionaries Koala and Hack. Unfortunately, he left before Luffy recovered and woke up, as he received word that CP0 were coming back to Dressrosa for the revolutionaries. However, as a parting gift, he made a Vivia card for Luffy and kept a little piece of it for himself, so that he would always know how to find Luffy if needed. He then left Dressrosa on a flock of birds and, well, I've got no idea what this is all about. Someone somewhere has some sort of power to communicate with, control, or become birds. But it has yet to be revealed. The final thing we've seen of Sabo so far is him returning to Baltigo, which is the headquarters of the Revolutionary Army, and reporting to Dragon on their findings at Dressrosa. He was also seen reacting to Luffy's new bounty on a cover page, but shortly after that, the island of Baltigo was attacked by the Blackbeard Pirates. Sabo's fate is currently unknown, however no deaths were reported, so it's highly likely that he is alive and well, or at least alive.